I'll research autism 2 or 3 in the morning. I'm just trying to understand my son better so that I can provide the best help and support. Evan is just a loving, sweet little child. After Evan's birth, he suffered from a collapsed lung.
They kind of thought he wouldn't make it through the night. They woke us up to go see him one last time.
And that is what started our road to figuring out Evan's differences. I joined Spark after hearing about it a bunch of times. We wanted to get genetic testing done, but our insurance wouldn't cover it. And because Spark is such a large research study, we had the opportunity to get our genetic information returned to us at no cost.
It was about 2 years later, we got an email out of the blue.
I was so excited when I got the result. These were answers that I was looking for, that I was hoping for. The genetic change occurred on Evan's CHD8 gene, and it was new to him.
So early in 2011, we found the first new mutation in CHD8. Back when I was first starting my studies, we really had 0 risk genes for autism, and we currently have about 200. Most of my research takes place in a basic science laboratory, and so I'm very excited to meet Evan and his family.
Evan loves the outdoors, and I love research, so today's going to be a great day for us.
We're still learning a lot about what happens to individuals that have mutations in CHD8. The most common features that they have are autism.
Good job, buddy.
So why is it that a change in one tiny gene can have such a huge effect?
One of the things CHD8 does in development is it actually turns on other genes that are critical for the brain to develop in the womb.
That is all during pregnancy.
Right, so around kind of the mid period of pregnancy. Okay. That's when cells in the baby are developing to become brain cells, and that's when many of these key autism risk genes are all turning on for the first time.
So nothing that the mom is doing or can be doing is affecting what's happening.
So this is just a natural process that is occurring in every child, and what we're trying to figure out now is how just changing one letter of the DNA code is changing brain development. Because some of these genes are just that important that you can't even change one letter.
So little things can make a big difference.
Yes, little things can make a huge difference.
That's amazing.